Hello everybody, I'm Scotty from Scotty's Clock World. Thanks for joining me back on my channel. I'll start off by removing the other bellows top that fell off its pipe. Here we go. There's the other bellows top. In the same condition as the previous one. They'll have new Tyvek paper on it before much longer. What we'll do now is we'll push these brads through and take them out of the side of the case so they won't get caught on anything in there. Now push them through. That one's going to be a bit obnoxious. We can get a grip to get him started. I'll grab a pair of pliers with some teeth on it. See if that'll make a difference. There we go. It is tight. That may have to come out. It's very tightly in there, that one. There we go, I think we've started him. Ooh, almost, tiny bit more. I thought we might have to take it out once we got the movement out of the case, but no, that's all right. There we go, there's the second one. Now, look and see what we've got. We've got four screws down there. It's a bit dark and dingy in there, but we've got four screws. Turn that on its side and start removing the screws that hold them, the movement into the case. Is that out or well, not yet? Not quite. I think it is now. And the next one up the top here. I'll be interested to see who made this. It's a regular. That case is probably a 34, but I haven't seen plates that look like that before. So we shall see. Not a bit hard to get out. All right, I'll take the movement out. I'll get those screws out. Right, the movement's loose now. I'll see if I can collect some of the screws. Always comes in handy. A telescopic magnet. You can get down into these things. It's the second one. Third one's fallen out into the case. And the fourth one's going to stay there. Right. Make sure the little bird, the tail of the little bird is down. If it's up, it's going to get caught in the case as we take the movement out. Found out what the problem was. I forgot to unhook the little bird from his door. That's why the movement wasn't coming out. So we'll have another go. Chains out of the road. Little bird's tail. All right. The case over there. There's our movement, suitably covered in broken down pieces of, I don't know if it's Tyvek paper, but whatever it is, it's certainly bellows paper. Could do with a very good clean. Not that we needed any, but if we need any more proof. Yeah, that's that link that I opened. Obviously didn't close it quite enough, and that's why chain's caught. There we go. If we need any more proof that this is an 8-day movement, it's got four wheels in it, not three. One, two, three, four. All right. I'll put that down there. And there's our little bird, of course. With his mouth opening. Lovely. I'll mark that position on the perch in a moment so I know where to put it back. There's our other screw. See if we can get it this time. Nope, still being hard to get on with. There we go, it dropped out. I'll put that with the rest. That's all our case screws. And I'll now put the little bird there. He can just sit there for the moment. Actually, I'll put him up that way. It's probably neither way safer. All right. I'll leave it very carefully for the moment. I'll pull the chain through the case. Put the chain over there with the other one. They'll both have to be clean. There's our case. There's the fourth screw down there. There it is. Fourth case screw. Put it with the rest. And I'll pick up that old piece of bellows paper that's floating around there. Before we start to put the movement back together, I'll take this down to the workshop and fire up my air compressor. You can see there's heaps of dust on that, but there's lots of little bits of pieces of gunk down there. I'll blow all that out. I'll blow all that out before we put it back together again. The next step is looking at the movement to see if it's running properly or if there's any problems that we should take notice of before we take the movement apart. But before we do that, I'm going to give it a quick wash in some lighter fluid, just so that I can remove all these little bits of material that came from the bellows, the paper on the bellows, remove them from the clock so we can see exactly what we're doing. But before we do that, I'll remove the pendulum leader, which has got a bit of rust on it. We'll have to get into that with a Dremel tool, but using two pairs of pliers, we'll open up this part a bit wider. Both of these rings will have to be opened. First one. Second one. Now we can drop that out. Out it comes. And twist over the pendulum leader. And it slides out of the crutch, this bit there. Right, we'll put that aside. Now we'll get some lighter fluid and we'll give this movement a quick rinse. I've removed the little bird from the movement and you can see it's pretty dirty. So I'll give that a clean. Let it soak for a moment. In the lighter fluid, and then I'll wipe it down with a Q-tip. In the meantime, I'll get some acid-free paper, put it on the desk here so that we can put the cleaner parts on it. All right, grab our little bird. And start rubbing over it. Oop, comes straight off. With a Q-tip. And get rid of a few years worth of dirt and grime that have built up on it. Careful of that little wire. That's the one that opens and closes the door when the cuckoo pops out. A little bit more down there. And that's looking substantially better. I'll get a cloth and clean that now. Wipe it down. Being a bit careful. using lighter fluid, you don't run the risk of smudging any of the paint or anything else that's on the bird that might happen if you use kerosene or other hydrocarbon products. That's looking a lot cleaner. All right, we'll put him aside down there on the acid-free paper. Now I'll put the movement into our tray. And I'll pour some lighter fluid over the top of it, making sure that we cover it all. I'll take it out and turn it round. Careful of the hammer, so that we can give the front a bit of a wash down. I think that's got a fair bit of an off. I'll grab a Q-tip, have a quick wipe over on some of it and see if we get any dirt on the Q-tip. Well, that's looking all right. Though, I think we might have solved the problem with that. Take it out of the lighter fluid. Give it a couple of shakes. Put it on our acid-free paper. Stand there for a moment. I'll go and get a heat gun and we'll dry off the last little bit of lighter fluid that's still on the movement. Right, we've got our heat gun set up. We'll put it on low. And run over the movement. Drop the back. Just to dry off any residual lighter fluid that's still on it. That's it, that's all it takes. Once we've taken the movement to pieces, we'll put it through the ultrasonic cleaner, then it'll come out nice and clean. Then we can start checking for bushing wear, if anything needs to be done, and making sure that the movement is functioning correctly. That's looking a bit cleaner. Little bit of Dremel work needed here and there with some rust. Right, we'll have a look and make sure all this is working and see if there's any problems we need to look at once we get it to pieces. Spin the great wheels round. That's a hammer. The hammer lift wheel down there. Regular 34 movement, sold by the Welby Corporation in America. An 8-day movement, as I've mentioned before. Well, that all seems to be in relatively good functioning order. Escape wheel's turning. Right, we'll start to take that to pieces now. We're going to take the movement to pieces now so we can put it into the ultrasonic cleaner and get it cleaned up a bit. It's looking pretty rough, as you can see. Powder and residue and stuff everywhere. First thing we'll do is we'll take off this pendulum leader suspension rod we've got here. We'll get rid of that. We've noticed that the low note cuckoo lever down here is caught in behind the count wheel, so we can't take that off. We'll have to wait until we take the plates apart. So yeah, they're all right. I'll see if I can. That's not going to be easy to get at, actually. There's heaps of stuff on it. Right, I might take that off when we get on the inside. Gee, they need a bit of a clean. Wow, fair enough. Right, we'll grab our trusty spanner. We'll start loosening these nuts off. On the pillars, take them off. Then we can remove the back plate. And number four. Okay, now start lifting, gently lifting the back plate up. Hopefully we'll be able to keep all the wheels in their correct positions. Whoop, other than the great wheels falling out. And we've got a crutch that's holding us up at the moment. We'll take that out. There's the movement, I'll put that aside. That's a back plate made in Germany. Wilby Corporation. As you can see, in serious need of a very good cleaning. Look at the oxidation build up on that. On every one of those holes in there. There's no bushings in them, so they're just holes that have been drilled or punched into the plate. Right, we'll take this apart while we've got it in our hands here. Okay. That's notes caught on there. They've got it turned round. Okay, turned round. We'll pull the high note lift lever out. And that is going to require some serious Dremel work. You can see how much oxidization is on that. Just scraping it with a pair of tweezers. All right, now the low note, we can now turn that round. That'll now come out. It's in the same condition. And the hammer lever has got a very fine spring wire that ties off in that hole there. So we'll pull that through. Yep, they've actually looped that over and underneath. Okay, there we go. That's undone it. Pull that up. And then the hammer lever will come out. Wow, serious Dremel work required there. And now I'll have a look at the count wheel. Undo this screw and hope we can get it. Oh, yeah, that's not too bad. That comes off. Look at the oxidization on that. All right, there's the plate. Patent applied for, etc. All that sort of stuff. They seriously need a very good clean. And that amount of oxidization build up there is guaranteed to have added an awesome amount of friction to the movement. All right, put that aside. Right, let's start taking the movement to pieces so we can put it into the ultrasonic cleaner and get it cleaned up. They're the great wheels. seem to be functioning all right. Now, that lever, I'll put that aside over there. We've got the pallets here. Will they come out? Yes, they will. Tiny little pallets there. Could do with a good clean. Good grief, look at the rubbish on that. We'll go over all those with the Dremel and bring them back. Start taking the wheels out now. Actually, I'll take that guy off. Has that got a... Alright. Put that aside. Now, second wheel on the time side. First wheel. Seems to be all right. Then the escape wheel. Obviously at the top of the train. Wow, we've got some work to do to clean those beasts up, that's for sure. Yeah, they're all in serious need. The motion work's not coming out all right. We'll get warning wheel. You can tell because it's got a pin on it there. Fly right at the top of the train. Now we can have a look and see what we've got here. Now, the rack stop lever, which we were looking at before, and we took a tapered pin out of there. It looks as though we'll have to undo this little screw here so we can get it out of the plate. Well, it's a bit tight, but anyway, we got him. Slide that off. Now, we can slide out the rack stop lever. Well, in theory, we can. We can get a little bit of a start up here with it, with all the crap that it's got in there around it. It should. Oh, there we go. Another one off. Pop that back on there for a moment so I know where that comes from. Let's see what else we've got. Little bird perch, complete with a spring there. Right, now we'll remove the little bird perch. We've got, there was those wires set into it, so looks like we'll have to undo these screws. Like everything else, they're pretty seriously in here. All the oxidization and crap on them, I can't even turn that round. Right, I'll go up to a larger screwdriver. I think this one, that's going to be too big. We'll grab another one and see whether we have any more luck with this. This is actually the correct size for this screw. Yep, that's got him. I'll loosen that off, leave it for a moment, up to the top one. Cracked him, all right. Now we can use a little guy. Got a washer underneath, so we'll be careful not to lose that. Back to the top again. And same thing. Unwind him. And that spring is wound around that post there. So we'll undo that. Couple of twists around there. Tweezers might give us a go. Right, that's got him off. Oh, there's a little bird's perch. Not in too bad a shape. Bit of rust down there will clean up. Well, we will be able to get that bit of brass off so we can clean that, the ultrasonic. And we're getting relatively down to the bottom. Right now, if I can get my pliers, we'll remove this taper pin here. It might, gee, it is tight. That's got him. Take it out. They'll all be replaced. We'll throw them out in a moment. We'll take this lever off. Everything's suffering from serious oxidization and gunk on everything. All right. Well, that's as clean as that's going to get for the moment till we put in the ultrasonic. I'll get that sorted now. And then once that's been through, we'll then have a look and see how clean things have come up.